Hello, my name is Mikko Uusitalo, coming from Nokia Bell Labs, Finland, leading a radio research department there. And it's a pleasure for me to present you Hexa X, the European 6G flagship project. So in the project, we have a vision around three worlds: human world, connecting, representing us humans and our values; digital world, representing then the information, communication, computing; and physical world, representing then the physical objects, organisms and processes. The vision is to connect these three worlds with the fabric of 6G key technology enablers. So us humans, we need to be efficiently connected with the physical world in order to be in good real-time control of the physical world, to operate the physical objects. Then also humans are efficiently connected with the digital world, making models of the humans in digital world, for example, being then able to make any predictive healthcare warnings, like predict heart attacks before they take place. Then the digital world and physical world also need efficient connection for more efficient operation and planning of the physical world. So based on this vision, we have been working on why 6G would be needed. What are the use cases for 6G? So 6G is needed for sustainability, to make 6G sustainable, but also help other sectors of the life be more sustainable thanks to 6G technology. For example, enabling monitoring the environment and making the operations more efficient. Then we have reserved a open place for additional use cases to come over the time when 6G is being developed. And then moving to the use case family of massive twinning. So we already have digital twins, models of physical reality built in a smaller scale. But in the 6G timeframe, we expect this to go to a much more extreme, making models of entire cities and large industrial complexes, making then the operation and planning of those more efficient. Then moving to the use case family of telepresence, so looking at the fully merged cyberphysical reality, so enabling a person or set of persons interacting with each other, no matter where they are, interacting also with physical objects, independent where they are, and all of them interacting also with digital objects that don't exist anywhere in physical reality. And all of these interactions together applied then, for example, for some mixed reality co-design, applied so in the context of work, applied in the context of sports being present at the different sports events, or applying then at some other cultural events or gaming. Then the use case family, robots to cobots. So how can a human or set of humans be working efficiently, being served by a machine or set of machines, also being made more efficient via collecting information and predicting operation and predicting the environment, and therefore being more efficient in the help. Then use case family, local trust zones containing various set of cases needing this secure local connectivity. For example, for some areas where there is not always any infrastructure present, but where it can become available. So then, based on the vision and these use cases, we have a story on what are then the main research challenges we need to solve. First, let's start from sustainability. So how to make 6G sustainable, but also how to help other sectors of human life get them become more sustainable via 6G with more efficient operation. Then network of networks. So we were envisioning collecting information on humans, on our bodies. So we have some very local connectivity. We can have this for a person or persons, or a machine or set of machines. And then we are looking at the different other architectural options and how do we get these different architectural layers play together in the best possible way. Research challenge of connecting intelligence. So having this AI machine learning being as a fundamental base of a new generation 6G, how would we build 6G if we take this AI ML as a fundamental base right from the beginning of the design of the generation? Trustworthiness. So we are seeing the very sensitive, private and sensitive information handled in the network being exposed to different new ingredients, more and more life getting wireless, getting digital. So the privacy, security, trustworthiness needs to be fundamental base in the design of the new generation right from the beginning. Extreme experience. There has been many important key performance indicators in the previous generations, for example, capacity throughput. We need to see that how are we taking them to the next extreme in the new generation. And global service coverage, touching sustainability via inclusion. How can we get everybody on globe as part of these services? And also, how can we provide these services no matter where the person needing the services is, be it in a very remote location, even in the middle of an ocean. So then, what are the important technical challenges we need to tackle on the way to solve all these research challenges and to create the technologies for the use cases? So here we can see the research challenges in the outer area, and in the center we can see 5G and the central technologies for 5G. So what are then the technical enablers for 6G? So terahertz is a technology that can help to cope with this ever increasing data rates. Then sensing localization, how can we get sensing localization information on top of the communication? How can we then get all of this work in an optimal way to serve these new use cases? Then the AI ML as a fundamental base of a new generation and many, many more that we are looking at in Hexa X. Then there are these new challenges, some of them are quite difficult to measure, for example, related to sustainability. So in addition to the traditional key performance indicators, we need to look at key value indicators, how to measure the value, but also then there are some new measures needed for the new capabilities, and also to measure overall end-to-end in the network. In Hexa X Consortium, we have an excellent team, so led by Nokia and Ericsson being technical manager, then three top operators, Orange, Telefonica, Telecom Italia. Then we have Siemens as a representative of verticals, other verticals, also outside European players represented in advisory group, other important technology providers, high quality academia, SMEs. The timeline for 6G. So HexaX started now beginning of 2021. The project lasts for 2.5 years. And now is the time for structuring and framing 6G. And we are then looking forward to be the base for then the next wave of projects coming from the smart networks and services, moving towards systemization of 6G, halfway through the decade, starting the standardization, and end of the decade, coming towards commercialization. We are, as a flagship, interacting with all the various stakeholders, policymakers, regional ones and national ones, other projects, standard development organizations, and for example, via many other verticals via this advisory group structure. Then we have a set of important demonstrations being planned as part of the project. Here is the first one of them, looking at some selected 6G candidate waveforms and looking at their performance in then real-time demo of radar sensing or communication and sensing, as well as then real-time communication and sensing performance. Then federated explainable AI demo, where you have end user agents sensing the local data and training an explainable AI model, transferring this model to other agents, and then looking whether we can show the predicted quality of service. Then demo looking at flexible topologies, studying them to be able to provide coverage extensions or service with low latencies, increased security or lower energy consumption. Then we are also looking at these flexible topologies, what could they provide in industrial context, for example, in case of identifying network fault, and providing some diagnostics based on this, redistributing the functionality and roles, and this in the context of robot-to-robot or robot-to-infrastructure or robot-to-human. And as a final demo, data-driven device edge cloud continuum management look at achieving zero perceived latency via AI algorithms predicting the future stages in the end device. And this demo is looking at showing the required actions from the orchestration point of view to adapt based on this AI algorithm. So thank you. This covers the presentation on the European 6G flagship HexaX.